Hello everybody, in this video review we will once again look at a couple of products which are interesting to discuss together. A watch, the Steinhardt Military 42mm, in this case the Black Edition, and the Mercator knife K55K, also called the Cat knife, as you can see why. So, and I will explain why I think it's interesting to put this pocket knife together with the Steinhardt watch. And if you don't like knives, then you just stop watching after the part of the watch. So coming now to the watch, I will later show you a lot more detail about the watch, but just look at it. It's a relatively recent Steinhardt model and I think it's a home run. It's very attractive. It's in my opinion much more attractive than, in fact, their bestsellers are Rolex Submariner homage watches. I think this one for more or less the same price is a lot prettier and a lot more characterful. But if you are somewhat interested in watches, you may think, and that's what some people initially said, yes, but Steinhardt has just copied the look of the Zenith Iron F Type 20. Let me show you the Zenith. And then we will explain more. Yes, at first sight, this is a variant of the Zenith with quite a manly strap, you see, a bit overly thick, but the general style is obviously quite similar. The Zenith cost a multitude of the very high value for money Steinhardt. Is it more reliable? Maybe, I don't know. Is it more accurate? Probably a bit, but probably not so much. But the prestige, of course, of the Zenith is untouchable. So many other of these Zenith Iron F models are, I would say, more elegant have more elegant straps. And often are quite big, in fact. But there are some smaller ones. And quite a popular model, despite the price. Now, you have to know, it is possible that when Steinhardt designed this military, what they call the military 42mm watch, that they were somewhat inspired by the relative success of the expensive Zenith. However, it is not an homage to the Zenith. We have to go further back in history. In fact, we have to go back to World War I, the era of the trench watches. So, in fact, what is a trench watch? A trench watch is a bit the intermediate step between the pocket watches of, let's say, 100 years ago and the modern wristwatch. So you can see here, this was a pocket watch originally, and they soldered lugs to it to put, be able, with a strap to put it on the wrist, because indeed, in the trenches in World War I, at the front, it's not practical to use a pocket watch. It was more practical to put it on the wrist. And that is how trench watches, you could say, were the precursor of the modern wristwatch. And you see a few other models in the same style. This is an Omega. It's very much similar. With a pocket watch movement. And those nice Art Deco letters and those nice old-fashioned hands, very similar to what you have here on the Steinhardt. And here a Rolex even, very different from the Rolexes that you know now, with also quite similar in style, I would say. To be honest towards Zenith, the Zenith is in fact very much inspired by an aircraft clock that the Zenith made in the 1920s and or 1930s. So, but it has those typical Art Deco lettering and also from the time those typical hands and the subdial of the seconds at the bottom. So that is what I would say. This is not a copy of the Zenith. Rather, this watch goes back to a nice tradition of very ancient watches. Something more. Oops, sorry, this is a bit annoying. Allez. Excuse me. Good. Yeah. Some more details before we watch more, look more at the watch. You will see soon there is also another variant in steel. The movement. Look how beautiful this is. Guys, come on. Look how beautiful this is. Focus here. This is a hand-wind movement, really like the old pocket watches. It is the Unitas 6498. That's the one if you have the winding crown here, and you will hear it winding now. I'm not certain if the microphone picks it up. That's the hand winding that you hear. And so the 6498, if you have the crown here, then the seconds are here. There's also a 6497 where the seconds would be at the left. But this is indeed an adapted from old-fashioned pocket watches, and still since a long time in production. This is a Swiss movement. The whole watch, by the way, while Steinhardt is a German company, is made in Switzerland. The Unitas movement is Swiss. Well, it is possible these days in this affordable price range that some of the smaller components come from a good Chinese supplier. Who knows? It's possible. Anyway, you see here the balance wheel that is has a very relaxed bounce to it. It's indeed slower in beat than you could say, for example, the ETA 2824 movement, because this one beats at only 18,000 beats per hour. And indeed, when you put your ear to it, you hear a quite relaxed ticket sound instead of the much more frenetic, stressy sound of the higher beat movements. In theory, having a lower beat makes for a lower accuracy, but in practice, it doesn't matter so much. I know it's just a few seconds off per day, so it's really pretty nice. Now, what else? Well, this one has somewhat darker finish. In fact, what Steiner does, they finish this movement with those what they call the stripes, they're called Geneva stripes. And then with an anthracite darker gray finish. So there is another variant of the watch where this is lighter. And you see some blue screws. So you see, it's really very, very nice. I think you agree on that. Very beautiful. And a gloss, I think, I'm not certain it's sapphire glass. I forgot to look that up, the back. So let's now look at the front. Again, the sapphire crystal, it's sapphire, it's not mineral glass, is slightly domed, beautiful. It's a double, it has two anti-reflection layers at the inside. Now here you still see quite a bit of reflection because, well, quite honestly, just above me is a lamp on the ceiling. And then you have also the black dial makes, in any case, it's very difficult to do away with all the reflections. But during normal day operations, it's really quite okay. You heard already, and you saw it in the initial picture, it's 42 millimeters wide, that is without the crown. Which makes, in fact, very easy to wear, as I will show you. It's 30 millimeters high, so it's really pretty slender. And 96 grams heavy, which is really pretty easy to wear. The lugs are 22 millimeter, allowing you for many straps. It's a very common size. Now, would you change the strap? Well, I think the standard leather strap is absolutely wonderful. They call this Russian leather, and it's embossed here. It says Steinhardt genuine leather, hand stitched, 22. Really lovely, huh? And here a kind of a logo, it says also military. Really, really cool casual watch. What else? Well, the crown you cannot screw it down, because indeed it's a hand-wind watch. In essence, you have to wind it every day, because it will last, I think, 40 hours or so. I haven't timed that. So you will wind it every day, that's why you don't want it screwed down. But it also means, in fact, this watch is not waterproof. You shouldn't shower with it, not swim with it. They say 3 atmosphere, which means if you have a little water splashing during washing your hands, it should not be a problem. But you shouldn't be doing anything else. I mean, don't challenge this. If you want to swim with it, then you buy another one. Look at the numbers there. If the camera picks it up, there's a bit of 3D effect there. These are, however, not applied markers. So it's not that they separate numbers that are glued on the dial like in luxury watches. It's printed, but in many layers. And that's why, and they do that on a few other watches, that's why you have that almost applied effect. Okay. And specifically, it's printed with luminous material. This is how it looks during the night. 3D printed Luminova. And they call this color is old radium. It looks a bit like indeed old watches where the luminous material was radioactive. And they color over time to this kind of color. So to give that a bit that old fashioned vibe. Well, it says here it looks like this. And I think I have the impression that the iPhone makes this greener than the somewhat yellowish vibe that it has in reality. But what you have with this Luminova, it is not super bright. It will last reasonably long because it's so many layers, but it's not as bright as a Seiko, for example. But anyway, it is quite nice. Huh? I want now also to lastly about this watch, before we go back to the real one, show there is also a stainless steel variant. Oops, sorry. There's a stainless steel variant, which is also very pretty. And usually I would prefer stainless steel, but in this case I thought that the DLC, the black one, is really quite special with these yellow letters. The DLC, the stainless steel one, there it uses white Luminova multi-layer, which really glows blue. And if you look at my older video with the Steinhardt Premium Pilot watch, it's that kind of material, which I'm certain will last longer in the night. But anyway, for general use, I think this is really quite acceptable. So look at it again. Let's see if I can focus better. Voilà. You see the Steinhardt logo there. At the top, the second hand in red, slowly moving. You see the somewhat art deco-ish letters, but not completely. You don't have the seconds or the minutes, however you call them, are nicely indicated with little white markers. And you have also the 24 hours clock there. Like often was done in military watches. You see there, there's the 24, 23 and so on. That's in the small red numbers. DLC is my first Steinhardt DLC watch. I've not worn it often. I hope it lasts well. In general, you have to watch out with DLC that it can be, if you hit things, that you scratch it eventually. But I think in some way this would not be too bad with this kind of watch. It makes it look really like a comfortable old jeans. Now let's put it on. And it's a bit strange to do this while looking at the camera, but very nice clasp, by the way. Also DLC'd signed with Steinhardt, as you can see. Really nice thick leather strap. Look at this. So my wrist is around 17 centimeter, depending on when in the day you measure, because it swells a bit, or during the day, as you might know. But I see a 42 millimeters is really quite cool for a casual watch. It fills the hand, it feels quite well. You see also the lugs go nicely down here. Ah, by the way, here the lug distance is around 47, so between the axis of the strap, to give you an idea. But it goes quite well down, so it hugs the wrist quite well. And you see, while it's 42, it seems in fact bigger. And that is because, unlike for example diver watches, which have a big bezel, the bezel is not so thick here. So that you have a lot of dial. That makes it weer relatively big and very readable, obviously. You see, quite lovely. Very nice casual weekend watch. Absolutely wonderful and typical for Steinhardt, really well made. I think you agree with that. Let's wind it a bit again. You hear it, I hope. See the movement again, how beautiful it is. Yeah, with such a nice watch, I don't have to say much. Eh? It's just beautiful. Bon, let's now briefly go through the knife. The Mercator knife. I've discussed this a number of years ago, but it's interesting to discuss it again. This knife is in fact made since 18 67. By a company originally named Kaufman. It's still being made. So it's really a success story. These days by Ottermesse. You see here the logo with the otter. In Germany. Solingen, Germany. Since so long. And it became popular in the West because Allied soldiers after World War II brought it home as a souvenir. And unfortunately, while it is designed as a simple utility knife, it had a bit, yeah, like often happens with pointy objects, it got in the 1960s a bit a reputation as a weapon because it seems, I found out on Wikipedia, that in delinquent youth in the Bronx used it as a weapon. So while it was originally designed as a simple utility knife. But you see at the time, when I mean 1867, it is very well possible that during the time of the real trench watches, people had this simple utility knife with them. It's really not designed as a weapon, but as a simple utility knife. That's why I think it's interesting to have them together. They're two pieces of history. So yes, it may be a simple utility knife because the handle is simply folded metal. The blade of most of these models is in is simple carbon steel, C75 to be precise. So it will rust, but okay, why not? You just wipe it dry. And it has a back lock. And quite solid, in fact. It's really quite solid. 90mm blade, 110mm handle, in total 20 centimeter, right? You can have a lanyard there. 3mm thick blade there. 74 grams, very light, very light. It reminds a bit of the French duk duk, but this has a backlock. The duk duk is a slip joint. I think it's a very elegant knife. And also, I mean, the traditional look, the black handle, the history, I think they go well together. Interestingly, Stefan, in his landmark book on gentleman pocket knives, I reviewed that book separately. It's really, if you are into gentleman knives like I am, this is the book to have. He sees it as a gentleman knife, and initially I didn't fully agree with that, but I changed my mind. I think indeed, while it was designed as a simple utility knife, it has a beautiful elegance to it. So, and as a simple general utility knife, good for peeling apples, cutting a rope, what not. And in my opinion, it does not look as aggressive as many modern knives do. There is a smaller model, I think the original one, that's the one you want to have. So a bit here about the K55K. The first K was named after the first company who made that since 1867, the Kaufman. 55 was the house number where the factory was in that street in Solingen. And the last K in reverse is for cat, Katze in German. So that's why it has that, this has the nice cat logo. So short, a very nice, very traditional piece, handy for general use. Has more character, I think, than many popular pocket, modern pocket knives. And it's just as capable, you know, it's very sharp, watch out with it. It's very useful. So in short, I hope you found this an interesting video. I discuss two highly traditional products. Well, you could say that the Mercator knife is still a relic from the past because they made it since 150 years now, and even since, let's say, since 10 years, it's not the same company anymore, but it's still being made. So this is really a hyper traditional knife. And by the way, here I forgot to say it's pinned, meaning you cannot repair it. It's not screwed, but this kind of simple utility knife, I mean, if you would destroy it eventually, which is very difficult, they're very, very solid, then you need to buy a new one. But they're very cheap. And in a way, so the Steinhardt is more a modern interpretation of that lovely trench watch style. I think it's a fantastically attractive watch. Perhaps you prefer the stainless more. I like both. It was an agonizing decision between the two. So it's a modern interpretation, lovely made, high value for money, it's typical with Steinhardt. This is the price in essence, that you pay for many quite boring watches in a mall. You know, that kind of boring quartz watch. This has a lot more character. Lovely hand wind movement. Quite accurate. Very nice finish. And very nice for casual wear. So, I hope you found this a good review. Show them again, side by side. Good. So feel free to leave feedback and see you next time. Then I will discuss the Seagull military watch. Goodbye.